bombing Vietnam.
Excuse me! Hello, come and lift!
I have the most delicious and freshest ingredients at my fingertips.
I've never seen squid that fresh. Look at that. Beautiful.
I experience the world's most extreme cuisine.
What is that?
That is the mountain rat.
You're kidding me, aren't you?
And I discover that in Vietnam...
it's still beating.
If it moves, they eat it.
Ah, shit.
I've just arrived in Ho Chi Minh. It's the foodie capital of the South, and I'm here to get my induction to this country's incredible food.
Went to the city?
Yes.
I've never been to Vietnam before, and I can't wait to get started.
For me, the idea of escape is to go to a country where you're not noticed, bed down. More importantly, turn the phone off and just disappear. I mean, really disappear. Just me and food. That's it.
It's 10 in the morning, and already it's a boiling 35 degrees.
Oh. I trust the air conditioner's not working then.
This country is famed for exotic delicacies and fantastically fresh ingredients. And I've heard the Vietnamese are a nation of fearless foodies.
They're rumoured to waste nothing and eat everything. Everyone says in France it's the nose to tail. Over here, completely different level. If it moves, they eat it. That's new territory for me. Here we go. Oops.
My first stop is the mother of all fresh food markets, Ben Tang. This is Vietnam's answer to our supermarkets. But here, the food is as fresh as it gets.
Wow, look at this place. Amazing. Where's the fish section?
Fish
section?
Fish.
Fish? Here. Oh, through there. Thank you.
It's the liveliest market I've been to. Many ingredients still have a pulse.
Unbelievable.
Everything's out, open. Fresh, he's taking the heads of the shrimp there. Everything's just so vibrant, alive. Fresh and kicking. Incredible.
Freshness is king in Vietnam. And I'm here to meet a woman whose reputation relies on it.
Mrs. V, how are you? Nice to see you.
Yes.
Likewise.
I'm shopping.
You're shopping?
Yes.
What an amazing place. Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
V Ching owns four of the country's hottest restaurants. She creates a new menu every day using the market for inspiration.
So this is your local market?
Yeah.
And how many times a day do you come here?
Twice.
The average person in Britain goes shopping once a week.
We have to shop every day.
Why every day?
Because there are fresh ingredients. You can see everything's still alive.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, shit.
Uh-oh.
Bloody hell.
And this is normal to have the frogs out here like that with their back
side? Yeah, so if you wanted to get one, they would cut it off for you.
So they just... oh.
Yes. This is how we buy it.
You so just buy them like
this? We buy the whole thing. You're not going to waste anything.
And what are they down there?
Catfish.
A catfish.
But you got to buy when everything's still like, whoa, that's strong.
And would you eat them that small, the catfish, being that tiny?
No, you eat the whole thing.
The whole thing?
The whole thing. You're not going to waste anything.
Heads.
We have no dairy, so the bone is so important to get some calcium.
So no dairy, and that's why you everything, the bone, the fish.
You got to eat everything.
You're actually shopping fresher than a lot of restaurants do back
Absolutely.
Home.
Absolutely.
All this leaping and wriggling might look the stuff of nightmares, but ingredients this fresh are a chef's dream.
Right, what are we going to cook?
V's hijacked a stall to show me how to turn these clams he's just bought into a stunning dish.
You can tell how fresh they are because they're just so firm. And it's like trying to get into the Pentagon. You can't even pierce it open. It's incredible.
The more fresh, the more harder.
My God. Come on. Yeah.
Then you put about 1/4 cup of shallot oil.
Okay, spring onions.
We mix about 1 teaspoon of nước mắm into it.
So fish sauce.
Fish sauce.
Yeah. So fish sauce, crucial to the ingredient.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So we mix some dressing onto each clam.
So how long do they take?
I would say that's about 3 minutes.
Again, it's all charcoal, isn't it? Because you don't have ovens. So everything's just sort of open flamed.
Mm.
That's incredible, that. Look how quick that
you
cooks.
See the way they cook. Oh, it gets so smoky.
Love it. Can't turn the gas down. Done.
I love V's no-fuss approach. In minutes, she's turned raw ingredients into the ultimate fast food.
They smell fantastic, V.
Mm-hmm.
Right, I'm dying to eat one of them.
Yeah.
I'm going to pour that juice on then, Adam.
Yeah, you pour the sauce on top.
Mm.
Nice.
Delicious. Who needs a seafood bar?
Mm-hmm.
We've got a market like this. My God. And I'm only here for a week, so what a great start. Thank you.
You're welcome. But I think 1 week is not enough. You
what
should
you
spend longer time.
So you don't think I'll learn enough in 1 week?
I think it's too short.
Too short. I'll come back at the end of the week and prove to you, okay?
All right, I'll wait for that time.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Delicious. Good
You're
to see
welcome.
You.
Okay.
Love the hat, by the way.
Thanks,
darling.
V has upped the ante, and now I have a lot to prove.
V has every right to doubt me, because it's an insult to her culture to come here and tell her I'll be up to her speed after 31 years cooking that style of food within 7 days.
But I'm determined to succeed. So, on my one night in Ho Chi Minh, I'm throwing myself in at the deep end. I'm going to a restaurant famed for its exotic ingredients.
There's a side of Vietnamese food that I'm going to have to get used to in order to really get my head around. The style, the real proper style of Vietnamese food. By the sounds of things, on the back of tonight's experience, I'll come out a little bit more knowledgeable.
I've got an invite to join a table with this hotspot's most adventurous eaters.
Hey, how are you? Sorry, did you catch your name?
Fat. Yeah.
There's not a fat person in Vietnam anywhere.
Yeah.
Right. Menu?
You don't have menu. The menu is over there.
Okay.
The Vietnamese food normally they eat alive. So when they're alive, that's even more expensive.
What is that?
That is the mountain rat.
You're kidding me, aren't you?
I said that people are gonna eat this one.
Look at him.
Yeah. Be careful.
Christ almighty. What kind of snake is
that? That's a huge cobra.
A cobra.
Be careful because they can spit out the venom.
Unbelievable.
Yeah.
Huge. And what do the lizards taste like?
It tastes like quite similar like a chicken. People usually like barbecue it. Everything is alive. When it's dead, it's not good anymore.
I'm all for trying fresh ingredients, but having seen tonight's specials, I'm wondering if I've bitten off more than I can chew.
Okay, so what do you fancy? Rat on toast?
How about we try the snake seven ways?
7 ways? Fried? Steamed?
Fried, steamed, stewed, and barbecue. Here we go. The snake in Vietnam, people they say to make you very healthy and strong.
And good for?
Oh man, good for sex.
Good for sex?
That's
Mr. Fat, when was the last time you had sex? With a name like that, I'm surprised you get anything.
In Vietnam, you go nhất giang ngu giao. I mean, one night, 5 times.
Yeah.
So you last longer once you've eaten a snake?
Yes.
Who's going to kill the snake?
Oh,
okay.
The waiter here.
The waiter.
Do you want to see how they kill the snake? Look, this is the snake.
Jesus.
See?
You're 6 foot. Jesus.
The thought of eating that turns my stomach.
What are they doing?
They would take the heart.
But I can't back out now.
Feel okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Couldn't have felt better.
So here we go.
What is that?
Snake heart.
That's the snake heart?
Yeah. You see that?
Look.
It's still beating.
You see that?
It's still beating.
Beating.
Wow. Yeah. Fucking delicious.
You can feel it going down in here.
Oh, come on.
Let's go. Are you scared? Don't scare, it's a power. It's a 1 night, 5 times.
1 night, 5 times, yeah. Unfortunately,
yeah.
My wife is 11,000 miles away.
Wow.
Ah, shit.
That's how strong the man is. Yes.
Shit. Jesus. Hold on. What is that?
This is the bite of the snake. Look at the color.
No. Okay, so I've done the heart, you can do the pile.
Yeah, no, you can try it as well.
Excuse me, I've just taken the fucking heart.
I did so many times already.
Come on, guys, I've just taken the heart, for God's sake. What's the matter with you lot? Cheers.
Wee.
Yes, the man, in a bouncing the head like you.
Yes.
Oh my God. Okay, here we go.
After the bizarre drinking game comes the main course. And there's a different dish for each bit of the snake.
And look at the skin. You didn't see the skin. That's Vietnamese way. They like it. Anything is very chewy.
Jesus.
After the skin comes the innards.
This one is snake guts.
Snake what?
Snake guts.
Snake guts.
And this is good. This is good. Oh, here we go.
What's that?
That's another dish. Come on.
Are we seriously going to eat that?
Why not?
Yeah. It's like something out of the fucking science museum.
The bone is mean they have a lot of calcium, okay? Right. It's good?
Yeah, I'm feeling, over the fucking moon. By midnight, I think I'm going to become fucking vegetarian.
At last, my trial by snake is over.
Ladies and gentlemen, good night.
Yeah.
Good to see you.
And I've seen a sight of Vietnamese food that I'll never forget.
Well, that was
experience,
good.
Yeah?
Yeah, I'll say. That was gross. It's hard to understand their sort of A to Z of eating because there's no stones left unturned. They're pissing themselves because, I'm not a man. I didn't do the bile and didn't do the blood, but I'm going to draw the line somewhere.
I've escaped to Vietnam and promised one of the best cooks in the country that I'll get to grips with this unique cuisine in just a week. I'm hot-footing it out of Ho Chi Minh City and flying 1,500 kilometres north to the capital, Hanoi.
It's a huge learning curve for me. It'd be very ignorant from a chef's point of view not to embrace their understanding of their waste nothing and eat everything.
Hanoi is a communist stronghold. Traditionally, this part of the country has a no-waste culture. They are experts in nose-to-tail eating, and one notorious female chef has made a reputation cooking just one ingredient.
Now, this lady's a bit of a hard-ass, bit of a legend. I'm in Hanoi for 2 days, and I'm here for inspiration. I'm gonna get in there, see what she's up to, and hopefully, like a magpie, steal some ideas what she's doing. Jesus. Where's the boss?
Hello.
How are you? Good to see you.
Chào. Sao đẹp trai thế?
Gordon.
Ông tên là gì?
What's your name, man?
Luckily for me, a local restaurant owner has come to my rescue.
Madame Qua.
Madame Qua.
Qua. Qua. Madame Qua.
K H O I.
Oh, Madame Quack. I thought you said quack like
Madame
the duck.
Quack.
Oh, it is quack. And you are?
My name is Rice. Call me Quan.
Quack. Yeah. Mr. Rice and Mrs. Duck.
Yes.
So where's Mr. Peking?
Yeah.
I don't want to piss her off.
Yeah.
I want to keep her on a good side.
All right.
Yeah, I heard she has a ferocious temper.
All right.
3 cleavers by the side of her.
Very sharp.
Yeah. How many ducks a day does she sell?
Madame Ngan.
Madam Nhan.
Ông Tây đặt cho Madam Khoa là Madam Ngan.
Duck Lady is the name.
Duck Lady.
She kill about 100 ducks a day. That's why her name is Duck Lady.
Tại vì bán nhiều con ngan, bán nhiều con vịt con ngan quá.
How many husbands has she killed?
One.
Mrs. Duck has spent 30 years perfecting her menu, but before I get to taste it, she wants me to meet her key ingredient out back.
What are these little babies here? How old are they?
Cái này để đây làm gì hả chị ơi?
They must be days old.
Bao nhiêu ngày ạ? About 10 days old.
10 days old. And how old are these?
About 4 months or 5 months.
4 months old. So which ones are we going to use first?
This is the oldest one.
Yeah.
Con này lớn tuổi nhất.
And this one?
And this one.
Nhiều tuổi nhất.
In order to find the plumpest bird, Mrs. Duck has devised a unique test.
Này, nghe tiếng nhé.
Why are we doing that?
Can you hear the sound?
Yeah.
Drum the duck to the ground.
Yeah.
Madame Qua never touch. Just listen to
just
the sound.
Just the sound.
All right.
So she's listening for a weighted, heavy sound.
Chân
can't believe I'm doing this to a duck.
Okay.
A lot of meat.
There's a lot of meat, yeah.
That sounds good.
I'm beginning to think Mrs. Duck is quackers, but her dish is famous throughout Hanoi, so she must be doing something right.
So this is how she prepares a duck every day?
Yes.
And it's important to bleed the ducks, otherwise it's going to spoil the texture of the meat. I get that. But why is she cutting it there?
Because here, to stay away from the stomach. You may get the bad food from the stomach into the blood.
Yes.
Yeah.
She believes in slaughtering them just before she started cooking them. So it's done that fresh.
So it's always fresh like that. Just always slaughter and then cook it.
So start off with the neck, yes?
Yeah.
Bật hết đi cái này đi. Xong rồi ta sẽ cho thêm nước
này. Take more hairs off.
Đây đây đây. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Cái này làm việc đi.
On the head.
Yeah. That's the labor of love. Does she never get bored plucking ducks?
Ducks give her everything.
Oh, really?
Yes. Houses and everything.
Con vịt này là ông thần tài của nhà tao đấy.
The duck is the goddess of her house.
The duck is the goddess of her house.
She says.
She's
doing it very quick. Go on.
Anything to keep her happy.
Now the dirty work is over. Mrs. Duck wants to give me a lesson in nose-to-tail butchery.
Straight down the middle.
Yeah. Pass the cleaver to her. She wants to teach you how to.
She wants to now teach me how to sharpen a knife.
Sharpen the leg.
Right.
Hey. Kung fu, yeah?
Mrs. Duck.
Yeah.
Straight off.
Okay. Off.
Yeah. Neck.
Okay.
It's amazing. But I've never actually slaughtered one in the kitchen. Taking its feathers off and butchered it from there. Is there anything of the duck that she never uses?
You see that?
Yeah. Oh, the glands. That's the bile.
The bile.
Very bitter. Yeah, if that bursts over the duck, it ruins the texture of the duck. Yeah, smelly.
Very smelly.
I'm enjoying myself. I'm about to learn Mrs. Duck's sweet and sour sauce. But all of a sudden, she's become tight-lipped.
So nobody knows this recipe bar you?
Only her.
Only
nobody
her.
Knows.
Okay.
Her life. So not easy to give her life.
I'm not asking to marry her. I'm asking for the recipe. It's you and I. Look at me. Mrs. Duck. Mrs. Duck. Chilies.
Chili, yeah.
Lemongrass. Oyster sauce.
Okay.
Yeah.
Duck bean curd.
Oh.
No. Sugar. Why are you being such a hard ass when I've just plucked your ducks?
She told you even her husband doesn't know about that.
Serious. My God. You? Huh? You're one off. She's unique. She's like a fine bottle of wine. They only produce one bottle. She's amazing. Huge source of inspiration. More importantly, she knows her stuff. I mean, big time. So she hasn't focused on 25, 30 dishes. She's just focused on a unique way with duck. She shows no mercy. Straight in there. Nothing squeamish about Mrs. Duck, is there? I'm a little bit fucking scared, to be honest.
While her signature dish cooks, I'm going to sample the rest of Mrs. Duck's menu.
So many different ways, different sort of styles of cooking duck. It's amazing.
You want to try the heart if you want to? Easier.
Nice and tender. That's good. That's very good. That's the duck stomach. Well, it's very chewy, that. That's nice. It's got a leathery liver texture to it.
Now for the main event. The barbecue duck is ready.
So it's mixed with the marinade and then on top of the charcoal grill.
That's great.
And then the fan, obviously, to intensify the heat.
Yeah.
Nice. That is delicious. And she's managed to use everything. Even there, as a piece of the leg, it's amazing. Delicious.
Okay.
Mission accomplished. I'm won over. Tonight's proved to me that the Vietnamese way of wasting nothing and eating everything can be delicious, and it's left me wanting more. The next day, I head south past Ho Chi Minh City and into the Mekong Delta. This fertile region is crisscrossed with hundreds of waterways. It's home to a floating food market where I'm heading to learn a Vietnamese classic that's essential to my culinary education.
Inside this market is a lady who's a bit of a legend. She has a reputation for her broths. And if I'm going to get up to speed quickly, within a week, about Vietnamese cooking, the broth is the heartbeat.
The broth queen, Mrs. Zihai, is a veteran. She's been selling her soup for 40 years, and today I'm rolling up my sleeves to work with her.
Good morning.
I'm Gordon.
Chef Luke Nguyen is here to help too.
So she's a master of broths.
She's a master of broths. So let's go check it out. Eh? The only way to do it is to get in there and do it yourself.
Yeah. And we're all going to fit on that boat?
You are, and I am as well. It's a bit rocky.
Jesus.
You right?
Yep.
Zihai's boat was the equivalent of a market cafe, and her soup recipe is the ultimate in fast food. And now she's going to teach me how to make it.
So, the broth. Where did the original recipe come from? Is it from her mum?
Just
from eating. She eats on the street, she eats in these little stores, uh-huh. and she trains her palate to make it the best that she can on this floating river here.
Yeah.
All right, what's she putting out there?
So that is the...
So we've got banana blossom there, bean sprout,
yep.
and then shredded water spinach stems.
Yeah.
And throw some vermicelli noodles behind you.
Yeah.
So here we've just got some hot water, water. So just going to be a lamb chow.
Okay, so she cooks it very, very quickly.
Now in Vietnamese cuisine, the clearer the broth, the better.
Right.
I mean, it looks like it doesn't have much flavor, but you sip it and it's just, wow, very complex.
Si Hai's trick is to put the dish together in seconds to ensure it retains its Vietnamese crunch.
But she moves so quickly. Thank you.
Wow,
that is delicious. And the fragrance of the herbs at the end as well.
Yes.
Lovely. Coriander, the sweet basil.
The texture, balance of flavour, lightness. Amazing. That's Vietnamese cuisine in a nutshell there for you.
There's no more time for me to practice. Today, I take Mrs. Zihai's place serving her regulars.
She needs to sell 60 to break even, 60 bowls.
Yeah.
80 bowls to make some money.
Okay.
So roughly she'll make around $10 a day.
Incredible. How much does that go for?
Less than a dollar.
Less than a dollar.
Less than a dollar. So we're looking at 50 pence.
Christ.
Should we get to work?
Yep.
Now what's amazing about Vietnam is this is how she advertises her dish.
Oh, really?
She sings it out. So she's saying both dishes, but she sings in this melodic tune. It's quite beautiful to listen to. That's what you have to do now. Durian.
Oh, fuck me. 7:30 in the morning. Singing for your breakfast. Hotel Bonville!
I don't think they heard you.
Oh, Jesus. Hotel Bonville! 60 portions a day minimum.
60. We're going to do 80 today. Let's make it some money.
Hotel Bonville!
It's really a great effect. Actually. That was really good. Look at them rushing.
Not one portion sold yet. 80 to go. Hotel!
Mrs. Zihai spent most of her life working this patch, but I could ruin her reputation in just one morning.
Hotel, Bonville.
Bonville.
Fine.
Bonville, okay, thank God for that customer.
All right, back in.
Okay.
Bonville,
come in now.
Bonville, all right.
Finally, bean sprouts.
No.
She said a bit more noodles.
A bit more. It's obviously a regular of hers.
Guy.
Yeah?
No.
She's saying you're doing well, mate.
One or two. First one of the day. God,
all
I love
right,
you.
Well
thank
done.
You so much. Hotel, Bonville. Jesus. Huh? It's incredible the way they work.
There's a lady behind you, she wants.
Jesus. Bum reel. Come on. Wake up.
Fuck. No. She said it's fantastic.
She's happy?
She loves it. She's happy.
This is serious grafting beyond belief. I mean, incredible. We haven't sold 20 portions yet, and not. Just the speed you've got to work at. I'm being self-contained all into one little spot here. Cooking without moving.
I've never known making soup to be so difficult. Zee's broth is a triumph, and I'd like to do it justice.
Hotel Bonville! There we are. Thank you. No chili. Thank you.
Thank you.
What do you think?
Wrong tea. No.
She's very quiet.
I think she's seen a customer.
Really?
She's
going
to rush out.
That's it?
Yep.
Now, hold on.
Someone's called her over. Back to work.
Yeah, what about my Bonville? Excuse me. What about my broth? Madam!
This is hot, hard work, and I only manage to sell a fraction of what Zihai serves up every day.
Please, enjoy. Thank you. Tell him I'm a chef in the UK, and I've never sat still and had to cook in one place for so long.
For that long. Bang, bang, bun. She finds that quite funny.
Có đen dễ thấy cực không?
She said, do you think it's hard work?
This is beyond hard work. I've been to lots of Vietnamese restaurants in London.
Yeah.
And the broth and the soup's absolutely fine. But nowhere near as delicious as this.
Yes.
You're an amazing lady.
A few days into my adventure, and I've got a brand new respect for Vietnamese food. V was right. Mastering this cuisine in a week is going to be a tall order.
I'm nervous because I wasn't blasé, but I thought Vietnamese food was similar to Thai, but it's completely different. So I think it's going to be harder to understand than any other country I've ever visited.
I've got just a few days left to crank Vietnamese cooking. This country has nearly 3,000 kilometers of coastline. So I'm heading to the pretty fishing village of Phan Thiet to see what they do with seafood.
This morning I'm on my way to meet a bunch of local fishermen who fish on a nightly basis for the most amazing squid off this phenomenal coastline.
I'm hooking up with Duc Chan, a chef who works wonders with seafood.
How are you?
Very well.
Good to see you.
Like everyone else here, Duc likes his food as fresh as possible, and he's offered to take me fishing.
They're not really boats, though, are they?
Oh, yeah?
Bathtubs, right?
Oh, there's tubs, but there's basket boats.
Basket boat, missing
a few more words in there.
That goes out on them has to be a basket case. What are they?
These are to go fishing, to bring in squid, shrimps.
Yeah. Yeah. And the engine, where does the engine go?
Oh, here's the engine.
I can't believe I'm doing this.
Pudding.
On there, in the middle.
These bamboo boats have been used by squid fishermen for generations. And before I go out fishing, I've got to learn how it's done.
Back and forth, paddle push to go forward, basically.
It looks effortless, it looks like he's not even doing anything.
Close with the water, no? Get your kung fu stand in.
Fucking hell.
Wow!
Jesus. God, I feel so stupid. Oh. This is probably the most difficult rowing I've ever done.
Hey! Later. Hey.
40 minutes later, they seem to think I'm getting the hang of it, though I'm not convinced.
Hey. Oh!
I'm now confronting basket case.
Oh!
What's he saying?
You're in for a race, dude.
Hold on a minute, Mr. Basket Case. He wants a race. Can I just at least have a 5 meter head start? Okay, you basket cases! Basket fishermen on your marks! Get set! Go!
Go! No,
no, no, no, no, no! No, no, no!
No, no, no! It's back to beginner's class for me. I'm stuck in reverse.
Guys, this way!
This way!
Wrong way.
Colin! Colin!
What the fuck? Come on. Excuse me! Hello, come and lift!
Boat's full of water.
That was hard. Bloody hard. I'm excited about catching squid, but not in a fucking wicker basket, no.
The best time to catch squid is at night. And as the day ends, the fleet get down to business.
This is incredible. They're now getting their tilly lamps set up. And the idea is to light the mantle, get it nice and bright, turn it around, and that will start to attract the squid. That's my boat. And that one there is Duck.
Show me your squid in 10 minutes.
Okay. Yeah. Bloody hell. Duck.
Yes?
What do they do out here all night?
Rice wine. Freshly cooked squid right on top of here, man.
They cook the squid on top of the lamps?
Yeah, and have a party themselves.
Incredible. Don't their wives miss them?
Their wives miss the squid more than their husband.
Jesus. Come on, baby. Where are these squids?
After 2 hours, I haven't got a bite.
Any pulling? Any squid?
Nothing.
But the pros have landed some beauties.
Look at that. That's what we came for. Those babies there.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Doesn't get any better than that, does it? I've never seen squid that fresh. Look at them. And now they are doomed for the wok.
We're going to clean it up now?
Yep.
We're going
to... Now Seafood Supremo Duc is going to show me a delicious Vietnamese favourite, stuffed squid.
We're going to use all of it. This is the little
beak?
Beaks right here. Vietnamese loves it.
It's a tooth.
The outside of it, it's like the membrane to hold the tooth together, so it's crunchy.
Oh, nice.
And the Vietnamese love textures.
In English, it's like eating a gum.
There we go.
Yeah, nice. So from snake bones to gums, yeah?
Oh, holy moly. Squid shooting, man. According to European, they usually eat that ink, you know? Black spaghetti or something like that.
Do you use it here?
No, not yet.
Wow, that's fantastic news.
Don't give them my idea.
That's the first time in Vietnam, okay? I found something you don't eat. Squid ink.
I found something the Brits eat that the Vietnamese don't. But for me, this complex squid dish beats our deep-fried version any day.
50-50, yeah? Tentacles chopped up and 50% of the pork.
Right.
A little bit of garlic.
Yep.
And a little bit of ginger as well.
We're going to stuff the squid. And a little bit of fish sauce.
I'm amazed you put fish sauce in there.
Well, I mean, if you don't cook fish sauce in Vietnam, then you're some sort of like foreigners here, eh? And drop it in there, please.
And now the base of the sauce is?
Ginger, garlic and onion.
Ginger, garlic and onion.
Yeah.
Nice. They look fantastic.
Nice touch, Gordon.
I've dressed a few squids in my time.
Right.
Haven't fucking caught many. I've dressed a few.
Well, you try hard, sire.
Yeah.
I can't wait to dig in and to see if the sea dogs are as impressed with Duke's dish as I am.
I've got the biggest piece of squid in for you.
There we are. The honour of my man right there.
Cái nhà lá vườn mà chú. Rồi anh em.
How's the squid?
Phù hợp với là khẩu vị của là tất cả anh em mình ngồi đây.
He said it's perfect.
Thank you for being so brilliant and so patient. Amazing.
Không sai không về.
It's a pleasure to see you here and you're not drunk. You're not going home tonight.
Is that the same stuff from his lanterns? No?
Yeah, go back.
Here we go.
Hi.
Yeah, Mr. Tip. Congratulations, honestly. Balls of steel.
It's been an amazing day. Getting out to sea and cooking the catch is as simple as it gets. And I've loved getting back to basics.
I didn't grow up with much money around the table. We ate in a very humble way. But here, even if you haven't got much money, you eat in an amazing way, a very fresh way. They don't realise to what a great standard they eat at so cheaply. Tell him I'm a lot better in the kitchen than I am at rowing. Cheers.
Cheers.
Thank you.
I've got one more stop to make before I put my neck on the line to deliver an authentic Vietnamese menu for my culinary mentor, V.
I'm feeling nervous, but exciting. And a week is a very short time to get up to speed with something so magical. But where I connect is with the ingredients, because they're the hero. Understanding them properly will be a huge advantage going into a challenge.
I'm heading off the beaten track into the mountains near Mai Chau, 130 kilometers from Hanoi. This is rice paddy country, and I'm here to get my hands on Vietnam's most important ingredient and to learn the Rolls Royce of rice dishes.
To impress Vietnamese people, one thing you've got to do first off is cook their rice perfectly.
Today the village are celebrating the end of the rice harvest with a feast.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Good.
Good to see you.
Sao is the only person in the village who speaks a bit of English.
That was amazing. Honestly, I felt like Steve McQueen. Now, I know I'm a little bit late.
Okay.
And the harvest is finished.
Yes, I'm sorry.
But I've just
about that.
Come in time for the feast, right?
Yes.
Look at those little beauties there.
Yes.
Hello.
Hello.
This Northern Hill tribe not only pick the rice, they process it too. But there are no mod cons here.
What's going on there? That is fascinating.
They cut the rice from the field.
They're taking all the little rice grains off the plant, yes, okay. And then it's all swept into the middle of the concrete.
Yeah, you have a chance.
This is incredible.
Yeah.
Not only that.
Right,
I've never been on a bike this long in my life.
You can go to Tour de France.
Yeah. I'm sweating like a Vietnamese pig. Is what all the ladies do in the morning? The harvest?
Yes. Sometimes the men.
Sometimes the men. Christ, I'm going to look at risottos in a completely different way now. What's the old boy laughing at? Hey, big boy, your turn next.
In this 40 degrees heat, I think I'd better stop before I keel over. Time to put all this rice to good use and learn what they do with it.
And what is this they're making?
It's made by rice.
So?
This is the rice and it's made with the water.
And so it's pounded rice?
Yes.
Mixed with water?
Yes, but not sticky rice.
No?
Yeah, not sticky.
What is amazing for me is the fact that we cook rice one or two different ways in England. You guys have put a completely different meaning on rice.
Yes.
And she puts onions and pork in the middle.
Pork and the mushroom.
Pork and mushroom. Incredible.
Thank you. Lovely.
For me to make these paper-thin rice cakes, I'm going to need to apply a delicate touch.
That's a great start.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. The chair's fucked. Sorry.
How embarrassing. Hopefully I can impress him with my culinary skills.
I've lost half my mix.
Okay. Wait. Oh.
It's what you call sticking to... to a blanket. Thank God I didn't grow up in Vietnam. You know, I'd be useless as a chef. Here we go, one more time.
There's a fine art to this, and I just don't have it.
No.
Come in. I'm not going to screw up anymore. Do you know what? I'm in danger of busting this chair. It started to collapse again.
No.
Delicious.
Delicious.
Mm. Very good. I'll buy some new stools.
The entire village have gathered to celebrate the end of the rice harvest.
That looks beautiful.
It is a feast.
That is a proper feast.
My failed attempt at rice cakes won't be on offer. So I helped to serve up instead.
Right, where do we start with this fabulous feast? Look at this. You take the rice and pass it along, right?
And news of my botched rice paper making has obviously done the rounds.
What's your job?
My job? What do you think I do?
You said that you are actor.
Actor?
Yeah.
No.
You are a doctor.
A doctor?
Yeah.
I'm a cook.
We are wrong.
Good luck for next year's harvest. Cheers. Happy harvest.
I have been useless, but Sal has honoured my trip with a gift of rice from the village.
Thank you. Wow, look at that. Lovely. That's beautiful. I will do the rice justice, okay? They treat it like gold. They show it so much respect. They have a huge technical ability to make rice so fantastic. It's at a different level.
It's been an amazing week, but tomorrow, it's crunch time. I'll be in Hanoi to prove to restaurateur V that I've cracked Vietnamese cuisine.
So, lots of things bubbling and festering away now in my mind, and all I need is to disappear somewhere quiet and just start nailing down those issues.
I've come to the end of my week in Vietnam, and it's been a culinary trip into the unknown and the unthinkable.
Shit.
My mentor V said 1 week would not be enough to master this cuisine. And I'm about to find out if she was right. I'm in Hanoi to cook a dinner for V and other top tutors I've met this week.
Mr. Rice, how are you, sir?
Oh, yeah.
Good to see you.
How are you doing?
Yeah, well, thank you. This place looks amazing.
Let me show you around here.
Please. It looks beautiful.
Mrs. Duck's friend, Mr. Rice, has given me the use of his fine dining restaurant. Its success is built on authentic Vietnamese cooking, and so it's a great honour.
The restaurant's beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
Who designed it?
I designed it myself.
Good job.
Worryingly for me, Mr. Rice has invited along 30 discerning diners.
You're gonna huge, huge challenge. And you know, tonight, so many people here just waiting for your cooking. And I say about 6-7 people, very tough.
Ready.
In 3 hours, the restaurant will be full. And I need to quickly get used to these unfamiliar surroundings.
Wow.
This is the kitchen, yeah?
This is it.
Everything here tonight is yours, yeah? Gas burners and grill.
Completely different layout of a kitchen. It's not like working with a gas ring burner. 10 times more powerful, a lot more instant. So, on the fly, yet again.
Tonight, my menu will be drawn on everything I've learned. I'm cooking pig 7 ways.
So starting off with the pork and shrimp, fresh spring roll, yeah?
Yes.
Can be served at room temperature. Be very careful. Pig's ear salad, blanched in a nice sort of spicy broth. Barbecued pork skewer, and it's grilled over charcoal. Then we're going to go to the sweet and sour pork ribs. Okay, after that, we've got a pig's trotter curry. After that, caramelised pork belly, finished with fish sauce. After that, the pork noodle broth. Let's go. Bye-bye.
My nose-to-tail menu is a tall order. I start with barbecue pork skewers, inspired by Mrs. Duck.
The shoulder of pork, sliced thinly, marinated, and then cooked on charcoal. Now that doesn't look anywhere near like Mrs. Duck's. At times like this, I wish she'd just give me the recipe properly. I think it's secretly because she had a massive crush on me, and she had visions of her and I setting up a restaurant together.
Next for my pig feast, a curry that I hope will satisfy the Vietnamese appetite for texture.
Normally when we use trotters at home in the UK, we bone them out and stuff them, but these are cooked on the bone and very gelatinous. Nice. Fresh turmeric, a little bit of garlic, ginger, fish sauce, and a little bit of fermented rice wine vinegar. Almost like a sort of light, spicy curry.
The pressure is on, and already I've made my first mistake.
So this is my broth. Remember, my singing ordeal down the river. I'm just struggling for that nice sort of lightly sort of pinkish colour.
I'm beginning to wish I'd kept things simple.
I've got one dish seared out of fucking 400 things to do. Fucking hell.
Downstairs, Hanoi's most accomplished foodies have arrived, along with my mentors, Mrs. Duck and Madam V, all here to pass judgment on my efforts.
I think it's a bit challenging for him because it's something completely new and very different to what you have at home.
V's premonition is coming true. I'm having a kitchen nightmare.
And the broth's gone cloudy, so I turned up the gas, and by rapidly reducing it down for some strength, it's gone cloudy. Here are the sweet and sour ribs. I want to put them in the oven. But they don't have ovens here, so everything's got to be cooked on top. Okay, pork, trotters, broth, ribs.
I think now he's in control. He's in control now. Because it's no shouting, no yelling from the kitchen yet.
Oh, fucking hell. Shit. Bollocks. Shit. They'd kill me if they saw that. Watch out, please, guys. Come on, you're out of the way, please, everybody. Everybody, the spectators.
By now, I should be serving up, but I'm nowhere near ready.
Skewers, please. Okay. Yeah, I need colour on there. I need colour. Come on, please. Yeah, charcoal. That's what gives the colour. Let's go.
It's gone 7:30, and Hanoi's finest have been waiting to eat for over half an hour.
I think in 20 minutes should be here. All the food should be here. I should run up to the kitchen and kick him. Kick his ass.
Huh? I'm starving. I need to eat something, and then I'll let you know. I'm waiting for a long time.
Skewers, please. Turn them over. Turn them over. More colour, please. Come on, hero. Yeah?
Finally, my dishes come together.
The broth is nice and clear now. I've clarified it. Some minced pork and an egg white to get it nice and clear.
My homage to Mrs. Duck is almost ready to be served.
Fingers crossed, Madame Duck style. Sesame seed.
And, at the last minute, I put together my pig's ear salad.
Don't take anything until I say. Don't take anything till they're fucking finished, please. Okay, let's go, please. Gently, 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 gently. No, 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 look, look, no, stop. Yeah, that one goes on there. Right, you come here, stand here. One bowl, hold the tray tight. Yep, and two, let's go.
At last, dinner is served. This has been one of the toughest nights of my cooking career.
I think what I want to say is this is very brave.
That was a nightmare. Struggled. Across the whole 3 hours. I'd like to think I'd done it justice, but I left myself a little bit short, to be honest.
But my ordeal isn't over yet. I need to face my mentors to find out if I've impressed them.
How are you? Didn't recognise you with no hat on. How are the pig trotters?
I'm not a fan of that.
Damn, what a shame.
I think it's a little too much caramel sauce.
Really? Too sweet for you?
Yeah.
Wow.
I like the pig's ear.
Oh, the
pig's ear? Yeah, beautiful texture. It's so crunchy. I love the texture.
Chewy, crunchy, crispy. Yeah. Soft and silky.
Got it.
The pork trotter, the pig trotter, is perfect. Pigs is the most difficult meat to cook. So it's really, really impressive what you have done with that.
The legs is too strong. And the color is too dark.
I think it's very difficult to do very authentic. I think this one is the I can eat this one, no problem.
Madam Doug, look at you.
Finally, I want to know what the doyen of nose-to-tail cooking thinks of my efforts.
Oh, my goodness me, what happened? Huh? That's amazing. Voy.
I'm happy, see, I'm being very pleased. She liked the best, the grilled soda on skewers.
On the charcoal?
On the charcoal.
Well, if it wasn't for you, this shoulder wouldn't have tasted as good as it did. Trust me. I'm so glad that you like that one. Good to see you, Mr. Rice, as always.
Yeah. So Vietnamese people is very hard to please, so... But tonight, Gordon, I think he does well. He passed it.
For me, one of the most thrilling 7 days I've ever spent in my cooking career. Honestly, if you want to eat well, get rid of your fridge. It forces you to buy ingredients twice a day and cook in a completely different way. Challenging week, yet for me, one of the most inspirational, big time. Crispy, crunchy, chewy, soft and silky. Right, airport. No macaroni, no fish and chips. We're in Malaysia, for God's sake.
You try your best not to get angry.
Mine's gone overcooked.
Is it part of the cow?
A bull's penis.
This is my clitoria bush.
Oh, come on, the Prime Minister's waiting for you. Prime Minister, absolute pleasure. The boat's filling up with water.
So, Gordon's...